Here's how I managed to fix 3D, once again, in OBS Studio. First things first, the concept.
Do you understand the concept, Lyman?
I've seen people put together those 3D Pokemon cards, and I really love the effect. I also saw this tweet by The Lightling about Marvel Snap cards. So I immediately thought, hey, there's a 3D effect plugin for OBS. How hard can this be?
How hard can it be?
You see, this isn't my first time attempting to recreate a 3D effect in OBS. Here, for example, I use the corner pin shader from the shader filter plugin. And something like the 3D effect plugin is great to match flat sources to your background, for example. Here you can see me use something similar to put all sorts of widgets as if they were in the room with me. So it'll take your flat source and it will deform it to give you that false sense of perspective. Alrighty then, let's create our layers and see how we can apply that 3D effect. I'll add a new source, make sure it's a color source, and we call it Backpack. We will select a color, something flashy, and a resolution. I'm gonna go with 600 by 900. It's looking good, but too sharp. I'm gonna go ahead and add a shader filter to round the rectangle. That is from the plugin shader filter. So shader filter plugin OBS, type that in Google. No shader text from file, rounded rectangle dot shader, and boom. Now I would like for my second layer to be an image, maybe a character. For example, this is a brand new character in Overwatch 2. Let's yoink that. Add it as an image source. And then size and place it. Cool. And then finally, we want a banner where we want some information to show. So we'll do the exact same thing with the color source. Call this one top. I want this to be a light blue. I want the width to be approximately the same. I went with 600. 250 for the height. Okay. And once again, we're going to place it. I'm just going to copy the filters on the background to get the rounded rectangle. So right click, copy filters, right click, paste filters. Easy clap. Now the animation I'm looking for is just a slight rotation from left to right to really show off that it's 3D. So we can start with the background. Since I have the 3D effect plugin installed, I can go to filters, plus, and 3D effect. Click OK. And now I have all sorts of options to rotate and position this in quote unquote 3D space. X rotation would be like this. So on the X axis, Y rotation would be like this. Now we can already observe our first problem. And yes, I do mean first. When the object is hitting that perspective, it's actually being cropped. So we could fix that by pushing it back in quote unquote 3D space. You can see position Z, I'm going in the negatives here. We could also play with the scale, but having to do that with each of them is going to be a nightmare. So to remedy this, we're gonna put each layer in a group, and unknowingly, we're actually gonna solve a second problem. So what I need right now is to create some sort of boundary box for each layer, but I actually need that box to be the same for each of them. So same size. And there's multiple ways of doing this. I'm gonna be using groups, and I'm gonna add an extra layer with the size of that box to let it know, hey, this is the size of the whole thing, basically. So let me create that boundary box first. That's color source, call it boundary. I'm gonna set it around here and 700 by, I basically added 100 pixels to the whole thing on each side. And it's pretty good. Now, this is not gonna be visible. I'm gonna bring it all the way down here, but we can have a good look at where things are placed right now. And I'm realizing that pretty much all of those are not centered. So I'm gonna center them, transform, center horizontally. All right, now we're gonna create a group, put each layer in those group and also duplicate that boundary and put it in each group too. For example, for the back here, I can select both of those, the boundary in the back layer. Right click, group selected items, name it, duplicate the boundary, copy, duplicate, put it with the character, right click, group, you understand. You wanna make sure your boundary is centered, Control D to center stuff. Finally, right click, duplicate, Control D to center, and we'll put it with top. What this does is make sure everything has a relative position to the overall form of the card. Because let's say this is our card and we want that tiny piece to be bottom right like that. I have to use a proper 3D software to show you this. Right now, the card and the bottom piece are rotating on the same axis. And believe it or not, they are animated to do the exact same rotation, minus 20 degrees, plus 20 degrees. But we can see that that piece doesn't seem to be actually sticking to the card. Actually, it's clipping. You can see it clipping. And that was my biggest problem. Something called the anchor point. Basically the point where all transformation is going to happen on a layer. And in OBS Studio, for the 3D effect, the point is always in the middle and it's always on the card. So in order to prevent that, we need the anchor point for that little thing. You see that little yellow point here? We need it to not be in the middle of that individual part. We need it to be unified. So it needs to be the same anchor point. In a proper 3D software, it's easy. I can just right click and say origin to 3D cursor. Now the origin or the anchor point for that object is in the middle of that card. So whatever the card does, it's going to follow. And if I press play, this should work. it does the exact movement we want it to do. And it's not clipping through, it's doing its thing. So I skipped you the whole trouble of discovering this with OBS Studio, but basically no matter where you move a layer in 3D space, the anchor point will still be in the middle. So you can't do group movements. You can't do layered movements unless you continue watching this video, that is. We're gonna turn off all of those boundary boxes we created. So boundary 3, boundary 2. And just to confirm that it takes into account the boundaries, if we hover over the groups, we can see that outline. We can see the outline. We can see the outline. That is how we trick it into using the same anchor point. So that top here, its invisible anchor point is in the middle, but with the group, it's actually in the middle there. So if we ever wanted to do other movements than just simply rotating, we could do that. Anyways, now we have to collapse the groups and make them rotate. I'm gonna go to the back group. I'm gonna add a filter. It'll be the 3D effect filter. Okay, that's cool, but how do I make it move? Using the move plugin, because it gives us a filter called move value. It allows us to basically control filters and their settings individually. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to select the filter here. It's going to be the 3D effect, of course. And the move value type, I actually want all of the settings because we're not just going to rotate it. You're going to see my little trick a little bit later. But yeah, technically we would want to move it on, which axis was it again? Was it Y? Yes, it was Y, like this. And you can play around with the actual 3D effect plugin to figure out just how much you want it to move. And my max here, it's like 3 degrees, 3.9, let's type 4. Yeah, 4. So it's gonna go -4 to 4. I'm gonna rename that move value to right or left. And I know that I want rotation Y to be -4. And that's gonna be our right. Okay, now we're gonna have syncing problems in the future. If we have all of those effects on different groups that are moving, it needs to know how to turn it on all at the same time. And I'm immediately gonna nip it in the bud by going to start trigger and tell it to only trigger this effect when this layer becomes visible on screen. Boom. All right, rotation Y -4 degrees, we have that. Let's duplicate that effect. And now we want the left, boom. And we know this is gonna be +4 or just 4. And there it is. Now that we have two things, one going one side, one the other side, we just need to tell them to loop it, you know? Let's go to the right here, scroll down, tell it, hey, next move should be rotation left. And then let's go to the left, scroll down, and tell it, hey, next move should be the right. And that's how you create a loop. Now, if I click on the right, it's gonna activate it, and it's just gonna keep playing in a loop, just like this. Whip, 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 whip. All right, that's pretty nice, but maybe we don't like the speed. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to custom duration on each and put the same. And for the sake of the tutorial, I'm gonna keep it pretty fast, like this. Oh, and remember, we made the right side visible when it was visible, basically to turn on when it's visible. We want left to basically stop when it's not visible anymore. So when you switch scenes, the animation will stop. So on left, scroll down, stop trigger, you want to deactivate when it's not shown, all right? So now it's gonna be super easy to add them to the other ones. I'm actually gonna skip the character one because it's gonna be more visible on the top group. Now I can right click on that back group, copy the filters, right click on the top group, paste filters, and it's gonna be out of sync. But if I move to a group where this is like none of those layers are, and I come back, they're gonna be in sync. But as you can see, it's still pretty flat, and I'm gonna demonstrate my whole theory about the depth. So what I found is that on top of the deform, in order to create a sense of perspective, we just need to swing it left and right. So if I go to position X on the right side here and I scroll down a bit, you can see that it's slowly, this is gonna be the top layer. So you want it to be pretty visible. And we're already getting a sense of perspective, except it seems to be like a little wonky, a little one-sided. So let's say -20 here, I'm gonna go to the left. And of course, we're gonna do the opposite. We're gonna go +20, and that's it. That's all it takes. So depending on the swing, that will determine how further away it looks. Of course, you can play with the rest to make it look maybe a little bit closer. Position Z, for example, I can give it like 10, and you have to do it on both because otherwise it just resets over and over again. And based on that, now I can copy the filters from that group, copy filters, go to the character, right click, paste filters, go to another scene, wait a couple seconds, come back, and everything is in sync. We just need less swing on the character to make it look like it's in between both of them. So filters, we're gonna go right. Let's go for maybe 12 on the swing. And there it is. It truly is that simple. And of course, you can add all sorts of effects to each layer, really. For example, from the shader filter plugin in the background, I added the ASCII. It's pretty cool. There's also the Game Boy camera effect. Now, since we put everything in a group, we can add new layers to those groups and they would still adapt to the whole 3D movement. So that top layer, of course, it was basically created wanting to put like a subscriber name or whoever's name. So you would want to place your text somewhere like that and then just pop it inside of the group. There you go. And if you already had effects, then it works. And yes, this works with every single source. If you want your camera or your gameplay to be part of this, you can do it too. Let's say I want some sort of separator here. I would probably duplicate that top layer, copy, paste duplicate, double click on it, make it thinner. Place it, change the color, and put it in a group. Ta-da! Now, if you use external software like StreamerBot, super easy to change text into, well, values into data. So if there's a new subscriber, the name would actually change. And then all you have to do is basically add this to your other scene. For example, this is my regular just chatting scene. I would add this as a scene. Now I didn't give it a name, but it's basically scene 3. Oh, right there. And with StreamerBot, you would just say, hey, make this visible. When I get a sub, make it visible. Change the name and then make it visible. Wait. They don't love you like that. And then make it invisible again. That's it. Yeah, but what if I don't like the character anymore and I want to switch it up? Double click on that image and all you have to do is pick another one. You'll probably have to place it again. Let's say we have Mei from Overwatch for some reason. Now, relative to the group, you need to just place it. Place her like that. And just like that. There you go. You want to add some filters to her or change the color, do some chroma keying, whatever you want. And this also works with widgets. If you already have like alerts or a donation goal, anything that can be displayed in OBS Studio, it works with this. Okay. I really want to make it clear because every time I do something, people are like, oh, I wish I could do it with this. And it's like, it works with everything. It works with everything. I just can't show you every single example in one video. All right. So this is going to be the Twitter clip. Hi, I'm GetLevel, and I just got done demonstrating how to create this 3D parallax effect in OBS Studio. Everything you're seeing here is an OBS Studio source or group or layer, basically. For example, the text, if you wanted to say anything else, you can just do this and boom, it says something else. Oh, that little top bar thing is hiding it. So let me just grab it and put it down just like that. And if I don't want it to be in a group, I don't want it to move. You can see that it's just a normal text. So you can use software like StreamerBot to change the text to display the name of a new follower, for example. Maybe you can make this a pop-up for followage where it actually displays the name of the person, even the profile picture if you want, and how long they've been following you. The possibilities are absolutely endless. Let's say that you don't like the picture of this character. Of course, I put it there, so it's just an image source. Look at that. Just an image source, just browse, find another image. I have this one, for example, and I'm just gonna place it. I'm gonna do this, do that, and oh, look at that. It's doing the 3D parallax effect too. Watch my videos, please. Watch my videos. Turn on notifications, subscribe, follow me on Twitch, talk to me on Twitter.